Was that a good thumbnail? Hello, guys. My name is Mike Kubera. We're at $312.42, but Control Finance went down. So if we go to their Facebook page, this is the only thing that we find, which is Control Finance 2017, the Asian page, where we have this nice little thing that says, "Dear customers, as you all know, we're currently experiencing an issue with delayed payments, but we're now establishing a new algorithm." Oh, totally. So this was 22 hours ago, where it is the 12th of September now. Oh, yeah, by the way, we're gonna do a quick little intro because I totally forgot about that. So Control Finance was a scheme. Turns out I was right, and Benjamin Reynolds is gone with $120 million. So definitely stay tuned for this. Also, I lost 300 bucks. Ooh. Okay, so here's pretty much what happened. If we go into our little Control Finance panel, we do have $312, which I will never see. As I stated, I was like, okay, 300 bucks thrown away, $1,000 thrown away. So I put $300 into Control Finance. I put $500 into BitConnect and $200 into Laser.online, which actually from Laser, I did get paid out and I did get my money back from Laser, and probably it's going to make up for Control Finance and this plus AdSense. So we're all good. We're profiting. But still, I did say, throwing out your money. And the links that I threw up didn't really make anything from that. And that's interesting because I thought they would have kept going for a little bit longer. But anyways, so the actual Facebook page, when we go to Facebook here, when we look up Control Finance, we do not see anything. See? So we have this, but that's not the actual page. This is Control Finance with two E's. And when you look up, this had 1,000 people liking it. There was 5,000 people before. So you look up Control Finance Facebook, and that's on Google. If you do it this route, this is the old Facebook page with 4,800 likes. You click it, and it says, "Sorry, this content isn't available right now." So what happens is they deleted it. And with this, they deleted their channel, all the videos are gone, their Twitter is gone, and they did announce that on the 11th, over 48 hours, people would get their payments back. Control Finance, it's over. Goodbye, $120 million silver slacker said. A $120 million exit strategy. What happened was it was pretty much a Ponzi from the very beginning. The way it works was there was a first wave of investors that put in money. Which, with Control Finance, it was a bigger scheme than BitConnect, in my opinion, even though there's less money you're dealing with. It from the very beginning, they did say, for example, this $300, it was gone. Like, you would never get that back. Even if you profited, you would never get back the original amounts. Which, for the people behind the Ponzi, that's fantastic because they don't lose money. They make money off of that point because you gave them money away. So that $300 or the $10,000 or some people even $50,000, you gave that up and you would never get that back. So let's say there was $10 million that was put into their hands, because we can't trust exactly what they said. They said there was $108 million or $140 million or whatever. Let's just say there was tens of millions of dollars that went into Benjamin Reynolds' pocket, which Benjamin Reynolds was a fake name. These guys were probably from Russia. And all the people threatening lawsuits and, "Oh, karma's gonna get you," and, "We're gonna get our money back." No, you're not. You might get 1% of it back, if anything, and that's gonna be years. So, with Bernie Madoff, the $64 billion Ponzi from 2008, pretty much there was a bunch of stuff from American Greed. If you went into it, there was a lot of schemes that went down after 2008 because everybody wanted their money back. They were like, "Oh my goodness." And when there's too many people that want their money back, plus there's the crisis, so the individuals know, like, "Hey, I probably shouldn't be giving up money." And there's billions of dollars that are technically missing because it was spent on yachts, on portraits, on mansions, on Lamborghinis, on whatever else out there. It was just burned. It was burned. It's gone. People who are making millions and millions of dollars very, very easily. It's just flowing in every single month. It's rising. It's growing exponentially with compounding interest. They're not going to care. They're not going to be careful about what's going on with their money. So they're just going to throw it away, and the victims will never see even 50% of their money or 25%. And especially in this case with Control Finance, since it was probably internationally, then America's not going to be able to do anything about that. The funds were probably laundered and they're gone. So Benjamin Reynolds and his team, the people behind it, there's millions of dollars that went into their pockets, and they probably have millions of dollars right now. If they really wanted to, if they were smart about it, they'd go and buy themselves an island. They'd go into unrestricted territory and they'd be able to do whatever they want for the rest of their lives because they have millions of dollars, which they're able to get even, let's say, normal bank interests, like one or, you know, a couple percent each year instead of like 1% daily or whatever it was, 10%. I don't even know. With that, they'd be able to live the rest of their lives comfortably without a care in the world. So this, even though it'll keep rising, tomorrow it's going to be like $315 or whatever, the 3% extra bonus, it's gone. Now, for those of you asking why I did this, it was a joke, it was a meme. Do it for the dab. Ah, my hair. Do it for the dab. So it's gone. And with this, I don't really care because I'm still going to get my money back through profit. It's like whatever. But I'm actually really, really excited that they went down. It gives me stuff to cover, and we all knew it was coming. But the people who were supporting it, again, if you invest money into Control Finance, into BitConnect, into Laser Online, into any other HYIPs, which are high yield investment programs, you're pretty much throwing your money away at that point. What's going on is you won't see their money. It's gone at that point. Most people won't make money off of it because it's just the way it works. So let's go into Laser here for a quick second. So far, affiliate commission, $337, but actually I will make more through other means. I withdrew $190 and I did receive $51. Oh, actually, this is interesting. So it says I withdrew $51.75, $24 here. So if you go to Coinbase, which by the way, Bitcoin's at $43.50, well, Coinbase's price. And if we look, I got $53.82. So I actually got paid more, $53 plus $24.03, which I withdrew $24 here. So I already got that back. I think this is going to be just fine in 24 hours. And boom, I put $200 into here. We're already getting back way more if I wanted. I reinvested a little bit. I think this is going to be around for just a little bit more, maybe a couple months, maybe a month, maybe 2 months. But still, there is time with this to get some money quickly. However, most people won't get their money. With this, it's interesting because it says $5 million and $277,000 were deposited. I think they're not lying about it. So if they're not lying, where is the page that actually says how much they pay out? Here we go. Okay, so I think all of this can be verified. They say they've been online for 75 days. They are approaching 15,000 accounts registered. They paid out $1.2 million and they're approaching $5.3 million in funds deposited. So this is the way a scheme works. They pay out less than they make, of course, and they pay out the people with the second wave of profit, the third wave of profit, the fourth wave. The fourth wave goes to the third wave, and it just grows. And eventually, there reaches a point with compounding interest where, let's say you invest a couple $100 and people said, oh, with Control Finance, my favorite thing was people were saying, yeah, so you invest $1,000 into it and you get paid $50,000 a year. This didn't even last 5 years. This didn't last 3 years, 2 years. It's gone. You have your money lost. And at this point, what they're doing is they're delaying. It's kind of interesting how they just removed all the Facebook, all the videos. They're going to probably remove the website pretty soon. And when the website's removed, what are you going to do at that point, huh? You're going to be able to call this fake number. You're going to go to their fake headquarters, which there's nothing there. People have called Control Finance's headquarters and they weren't able to figure out what's going on. The only people I feel bad for are those who fell under affiliate commissions, who actually didn't know, well, affiliate links, who didn't know that this would fall. But everybody's greedy at this point. If you are investing even $10 and you are thinking you're going to make $1,000 from it, well, either you know exactly what this is, which is an HYIP. For those, I don't feel bad because you willingly put your money in there. Actually, everybody willingly put their money in there. No one forced them to throw down $1,000. And especially if you're getting into the range where people are throwing thousands or tens of thousands, then, you know, I can't feel bad for you. I cannot feel bad for you. Control Finance is a little bit of a different vehicle than BitConnect, though, and Laser. I think their own where control finance didn't really care. I feel like Laser went out a little bit more. Laser, for example, you're able to see their ads on CoinMarketCap. And some people are believing that Laser is going to stay around. Some people thought control finance is going to stay around forever. Some people think that that's the case with BitConnect. I feel that they're all going to fall eventually. But then again, you know, there's some people that compare this to cryptocurrencies. So one of the most interesting things with this is the regulations. Now, with Russia, with America, there's more and more regulations coming out for cryptocurrencies. However, with that, it's still a little bit weird at the moment, where it's like, technically, for some of this stuff, technically, it's not illegal. Not everything they're doing is illegal, where straight up, if you went and did an IPO and you got millions of dollars and then you just went away with it, there are people going to jail for doing ICO scams or whatever, something like this. But it all depends on where you're based out of, where the money's going in and out of, if you're accepting U.S. investors. And it's kind of a tricky process at that point. I'm not exactly sure about the legalities of that. I still think, like, if you're an investor in this, and even if you ran one of these websites, if you knew exactly what you were doing, you'd be able to fly under the radar, where you'd be able to make money, get out, no one would find you, and there we go. So the last thing I'm going to do, parting words here. People are angry. Benjamin Reynolds is a fake name. We all know you're scammers, but now you won't go free. Mark my words, karma will get you. No, it's, they're probably going to be living off with millions of dollars. The main page of CF is can't reach now. Haha, they gone. Guys, it's 9/11. I like how they chose the date, by the way. Goodbye, Control Finance. Ooh, Sheila over here. 100,000 deposit, 100% referral bonus kickback. Oh, totally. No reply from admin. So many mails sent to them. Seems my $500 has been gone away with. Sharma lost it. Are you sure you're dealing with it? Why won't you keep your promise? Oh, yikes. All right, guys. Well, oh, there's one person. If we can locate their admin, if we can locate, where is it? If we can locate their website register and track the scammer down, that would be great. No, they probably did fake details. You don't think they thought about this? It's interesting how they left their Asia page up, but all right. Well, that's that. My name is Mike Kubera. What do you guys think about this? Do you think it might come back? Maybe Benjamin Reynolds will come back and be like, oh, everybody, it's done. The main thing is, I'm still a little surprised though. They probably weren't greedy enough, as in they should have kept it going for another 6 more months, because at that point they could have doubled their money. But it depends on what they're doing with. Anyways, maybe they just wanted a couple $1 million. They're millionaires. You lost your money. This $300, it can grow to $1,000 even if they leave the website up. I will never be able to withdraw it, and particularly, I don't care. I threw it out. Whatever. That's the mentality you should be going into it. It was for jokes. It was for memes. My name is Mike. I'm actually, you know, if they do go down, if they do fully go down, oh my goodness. It's a happy day. It's a happy day, my friends. We shall see you guys tomorrow. If you enjoyed this video, please leave a like, comment, subscribe, and share. And yeah, I'm happy that people are enjoying the new intro. Fantastic. All right, we'll see you guys tomorrow. Bye.